Well, top of the morning to you, fam. Moma, Austin, we're in Big Sur, and we're about to do the Buzzard's Roost Loop. Now, the interesting part of this is that we are starting in the Fernwood RV Resort, which is where we are camping. So it's gonna be a little longer than the 2.8 miles that's listed on all trails, but we're gamers today, so let's get after it. Cool thing about this campground that we're in is that the river runs right through it, which is awesome. You get that beautiful babbling sound that just with the windows open in our trailer. It's incredible. This place is beautiful. Obviously, the path is very well defined to get to the state park we're headed to, right? So this hike is inside the Pfeiffer State Park. Our campground's outside that. You hike through it to get to the hike we're going to, which is pretty amazing. But look at this. Man, incredible. We are literally just hundreds of feet into this hike, and look at this. Oh my God. Incredible. Wow, and you can see there was a fire of some sort that went down here, but man, incredible just how tall these trees are towering over you. It's breathtaking. Amazing. We're just wandering around this trail, and again, we're into another very large grove of trees. You can see some of that fire damage from the most recent fire, but just absolutely majestic place. Oh my God. This is an incredible little hike. Yeah, we're only a few minutes into this, but this place is stunning. Oh, and I found a sign here. Franby Wolf Grove is what we're looking at right now. And again, you can see some of that fire damage over there in that grove, but absolutely beautiful. Onward and upward. A mile from our campsite, we have hit the telltale sign of where we need to head. So here we go. Well, we're about a mile in, at a bit of elevation. Not too much yet, but on all trails, looks like it's 1,700 feet of elevation. Tracking on my watch, so I'll let you know for sure. But a beautiful place, just past another grove, rivers off to the left, serene, peaceful. Ton of birds chirping away. Epic place. I can't help but continue to narrate what we're seeing. Look at this incredible grove. Absolutely amazing. And there is little Miss Momo. Sun's starting to peek out, and you're getting a view across the way of some of the mountains over there, which is beautiful. And then the buzzing in the background lets you know people are around. We're close to, I think, the Big Sur Lodge that's located around the Pfeiffer State Park area. Sounds like they're doing some yard work. All right, well, 1.5 miles in, we've made it to the loop. We're gonna go
right.
counterclockwise is where we're headed.
Yeah.
And so far we've gained about 400 feet of elevation. I've had to strip down a few layers because I am sweating, but look at these views. Stunning. It's been a minute since we've gotten in a proper hike. This is amazing for the soul. That excitement of what's around the next bend, the next tree, the next boulder is really catching me right now. I'm exhilarated and feel alive. How can you not when you're in a place like this? This has escalated quickly. 731 feet of elevation. So I've added another 300 feet in a very short amount of time. It is whooping my butt. At about 860 feet of elevation, you clear the trees and there is a radio tower or something right up here, which is probably Buzzard's Roost, but don't know if you'll be able to see it in this video. That is the Pacific Ocean. What a sight to behold. Getting to the roost itself, and what an epic, epic spot. Wow. Again, look at that Pacific Ocean. You've got these incredible views of the mountains. And there is what we are assuming is the Buzzard's Roost. What do you think, love?
Thumbs up.
And as the name implies, there goes one. Beautiful spot. You can see there's some crazy trail across the way on that mountain over there. Maybe another day. Not today, but we are finishing this loop portion. Looks like we're headed back down into another amazing looking redwood grove. And just enjoying this beautiful Saturday afternoon. This has been a beautiful early afternoon hike. We have seen exactly one couple hiking this trail, that's it. So depending on what time of year you're coming, you may be the only person out on this, and that's pretty amazing. Beautiful. It is mesmerizing staring at these incredibly large trees and just thinking about how old they are. Really keeps you awestricken on how amazing our world is. Don't you think? While we haven't made it to the end of the loop, I can definitively tell you that going counterclockwise gets you to the climax quicker. So if you want a long, drawn out anticipation of what's at top, I would go clockwise, not counterclockwise. Outside of that small grove, this side of the hike so far isn't as beautiful as the hike portion we went up on the counterclockwise portion of the loop. Just something to keep in mind as you're going. This is more like an overgrown backyard than the beautiful forest we saw earlier. We were just talking to some fellow travelers that are about to start the loop and giving them our opinion. So they seem very happy about our recommendation to go counterclockwise and get to the peak quicker. See that epic view. See that? Helping people. Who would have thought your boy would be helping people? If you've never been to the Big Sur area of California, I highly recommend you figure out how to get there and spend a weekend, a week, just traversing. Number one, the beautiful drive. It is an absolutely epic drive. One you need to research though, because there are quite a few landslides that happen. So PCH, which is Highway 1 here, can be closed at times. It is currently closed about 13 miles down the highway from us, so you can't fully take it. But if you came up here and started your journey, say in Monterey Bay, which is a beautiful place, worked your way through Big Sur down to Morro Bay, you would have so many memories and see so many things that will just stay with you forever, because it is a stunning area of California. So I highly recommend it. Please get out there and do that. And treat yourself, because you are worth it. We haven't talked at all about it, but the smell is just incredible. That smell of decaying old foliage just has a very comforting and calming effect. And it is prevalent all over here. At the very first sign where it says group camping, we veered off and went that way just to explore a little bit. And there's a beautiful kind of outdoor amphitheater. Looks like this would be the area the orator or speaker would be at. Maybe a little fire pit over there. Looks like quite the cool little spot. This is, I think, close to the Big Sur Lodge, so there's probably something amazing they do or used to do when it comes to the experience. Now I'm just kind of bumbling along. Check out the river. It's beautiful, calming. Again, hardly anyone here, although you can see PCH there. It's a beautiful stretch of unclaimed river, all for me. All of this buildup at the river just shows you how powerful that river could be. That is a ton of trees and branches, and probably some of these rocks also moved. Very intimidating to think about. Alright, well, that was easy. I wanted to quickly show you though where we're staying, because it is an awesome little site. So this area has cabins, has yurts, has hardcore camping, has full hookups, which is what we're doing. And we are right over here in this big, beautiful grove. Right there in our new, beautiful little trailer. Ain't she a beauty? Absolutely love it. And we've got a beautiful, beautiful view right here where we had coffee this morning. Not a lot of better views than that. Cheers. We're wrapping this hike up at the little bar and tavern that's at the top of the campsite area. Getting some well-earned nachos and a Philly cheese. What a beautiful and blessed day. Thank you guys for joining us. If you want to go on more of these adventures with us, please like it, subscribe. Hit that notification button so you can see what we do next. I'm gonna wrap up here, eat, and wife and I are gonna go on some private adventures, but thanks for sticking around. We'll see you on the next one.